Hi everyone, it's Tammy with the Frou-frou Studio. Welcome back for another episode of nothing but neutrals. This is a weekly challenge that I came up with to use up scraps mainly, and also to work with just neutrals. We had spent about a year and a half or so working on color combinations and bringing color into our makes. And so I decided after doing that for so long that I would switch it up and I would make it a challenge where you can't use any color. So if you are participating, thanks. If you're new and want to start participating, that's awesome. The only thing that I give you is I give you the base product that you're supposed to use for the week. Everything else is up to you. And the only really rule is that you can only use neutrals, which are black, white, gray, and brown, or any shade or variation thereof. With that being said, I picked a guest check as this week's base, not thinking that guest checks are not neutral colors in most cases. I have seen some gray ones. I do not have the gray ones. Most of them are green or pink or blue or, you know, there's some color. So, it's perfectly all right this week to use one that has color if that's what you have. I had originally thought that I was going to run a copy and use a, you know, just black and white photocopy. But I have since decided to cover it with this tissue paper because I am working on a kind of a travel journal. And I have this tissue paper that has a map on it. And I think if I put this over this, you're still going to be able to tell it's a guest check underneath. But it's going to take most of the color out of it. So, that's what I'm going to do. And I'll do that first. The back side I've covered with coffee dyed paper so that we can have a nice neutral back and have a place to write on and also to make it a little stiffer. So, now I'm going to, not that side, Tammy, I'm going to cover this front with the tissue paper and then we'll get started with our make. Yeah, I just was not thinking. I was just going to be making a list of bases that you could use, and guest check is always a great base, and I put, oh, guest check. And then when last week when I was going to give the option for this week, I thought, well, you know, yeah, you said guest check and they're not neutral, but like I said, use what you have and it'll be fine. It's my fault. So I'm just going to lay this down on here and kind of press it down. And you're going to be able to see a lot or some of the colors still coming through, but it's going to take a lot of the color out. So I think we can make it work. So I'm going to very gently try to get some of the wrinkles out of this. I don't care if a few remain. So I hope everyone is doing awesome today. I'm filming this on Monday. So if you made it through Monday, I say kudos. Anytime you can make it through Monday is a good week. Gonna be a good week. I think. Alright, so there is that covered. I'm going to trim around it, and then we will continue. I think I'm going to make this a tag, because I already have a pocket in my journal for it to go in, which is not neutral, but I will show it to you anyway. Get this trimmed up. So I hope everyone is liking the challenge. You seem to be from the comments, and your makes are wonderful. And if you do post to social media, if you'll use that hashtag, nothing but neutrals, I can find your post and see the beautiful things that you're making. And so can everybody else that is participating. I do have a playlist on my channel if you want to see what the previous week's bases were. Okay, there we go. So let's do the tag thing. Yeah, I think I want to make it a tag. Paper stuck to me. So I'm gonna try to snip some corners here and hope that it's dry enough that it'll take them off. I think if I use my crocodile, it shouldn't have a problem. I say that. Okay, so there's a little bit of a problem. Best case scenario, you'd want this to dry before you snip your corners. But for the sake of the video, now, what kind of hole? I think I'm gonna put like a slot in. No, I'm gonna do a circle. I was trying to say a slot, but I think I want to do a circle. So I'm going to put it like estimated middle and see, that's barely did its thing there because it's still wet. Okay, sorry for the reach there, and let's put some hole reinforcers on there. Alright, and ink around it. Now, normally I would use like cardstock and make this a really stiff tag, but this particular journal, because it is a travel journal, and could be possibly taken, you know, on a trip or whatever, I wanted to try not to bulk it up too bad. So, that's why I did just the coffee dyed regular paper on the back, because it doesn't make it too terribly thick. And I really like the flexibility when you do this with the tissue paper. It makes it feel almost like fabric. So there's the tag. Now, to decorate the tag, I have, this is from, some scrapbook paper that I have. I'll show you the paper pad. through a staple pad. It's in my envelope over here. It has all my paper for the journal I'm working on. It is this paper pad. And it is called the Maps, Text, and Leisure Stack. And it is manufactured by Fabric Par DCWV Incorporated. And it is just a stack of papers that has different kinds of maps in it. And it has these little cutouts that you can use in a travel journal. So the particular one that I have for this make is our road trip. And so I think I want to use this, and you can jot down, you know, your little trip details on here. And I have a die cut of the Eiffel Tower that I think I want to use. I don't know how I'm going to incorporate this stuff yet. And then I have this Tim Holtz photo that has this cool car on it with these, this family that I'm thinking is taking a trip to Paris. And then I have this vintage key that I actually got in Paris. And I have this little coffee dyed like tag. And I'm going to incorporate that somehow. And I thought about putting the photo in this little plastic bag. And putting some alcohol ink on the plastic bag. Just for something different. And then I may hang that on there like that. So, let's see how I want to do this. I may put that on the back. Put this back here. I thought it'd be kind of cool to incorporate the Eiffel Tower since we have the Olympics going on right now. They might be traveling to the first Paris Olympics, which I don't know what year that was. May just be reaching. And the pocket, see, I've got this too. Do I want to incorporate some of that? No, I don't think so. We may do a stamp. See, maybe these are Tim Holtz. Let's see if I have something neutral that is French, green. And here's the browns. I don't know if you can even tell where. There's one from Belgium. Australia. Yeah, I like this one with the number 3 on it. I can't tell where it's from. But I like that it has a number 3. Maybe we'll use that one. We'll stick this one over to the side. And then maybe kind of a gold beigey gold color. Like to the tan side, not to the yellow side. This might be all too yellow. Blues and greens. Oh, there's some more browns. Canada. Stick that one over to the side. Okay. So let's decide, do I want to let's put some alcohol ink on this bag and see what it looks like. Get situated here and get this. Gotta get this tissue out of the way. It'll stick to everything. Alright, so there's my bag. Let me grab my ink. Okay, so I'm going to try sepia. I'm just going to put some on here. And then I'm going to take my little dauber thing. I don't want it to get so dark that you can't see the picture through it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna smear it all on here. And then I'm gonna get some of my alcohol. And this is 99% alcohol. Okay, that should take just a second to dry. So while that is drying, we will put our Eiffel Tower and stuff on. So I'm going to use art glitter glue, and this is just cardstock, and it has a black soot around the edges, and I had it already in my stash, so I just grabbed it out when I saw it. Okay, yep, yeah, paper towel here. And that glue will dry clear, so I'm not worried about that. All right, so now how do I want to incorporate this? Do I want to put this down at the bottom? All right, let's see what this looks like. So my idea is to put the photo in here. Let's wrap this up first. I can't decide what I'm doing, can I? Let's do this, let's do that. If you don't have one of these little tools, you can use the edge of your scissors. I do find that these new cards are a little bit thicker, and where some of the others you can use your nails, these are a little thicker and they're not as easy, but they do, you can use your scissors or you can use the little sanding disc. Bend some of the corners up and maybe even make a couple of cracks in here. All right, and then I'm gonna use vintage photo, go around the edges and try to pick up on those cracks a little bit as well. All right, so let's put this in here. Oh yeah, I like that. So if I were to take this and this, I Okay, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to staple this with the tiny attacher at this angle. And I'm going to staple it down here at the bottom. And I'm going to staple it and staple this key on here, I hope. If I can hit it right. Now what I have is kind of a tuck, and then I can tuck this on here however I want to. And I think what I may do is fold it. And tuck it in there. And then when it's out, put a stamp there. Then I think I'll put another one over. I think I'm going to put it right over the staple there. I don't think that'll block my tuck too much. Nope. Do I want to do that, or do I want to put this on the back? I think I'll put this on the back, actually. And I think I'm going to put it on with a piece of old tape. Tim Holtz old tape. And then, you can write on that, but you'll also be able to flip it up and write on the rest of the page if you want to. Yeah, ooh, that needs to be covered on the back, doesn't it? That's way too white for the back of that. So, let's cover it with the same coffee dyed paper. It'd have been good to think of that before I taped it, but that's okay. We'll put a piece of tape on the inside as well. Alright, let me see if I can get this off. Nope. Yeah, that tape, the one thing I will say about that tape is once it's down, it's down. And I don't want to tear up what I've done, so I'm just going to try to reach it the best I can here. All right, I'm gonna put some ink along those stamp edges. I'm gonna stamp something on this too. So looks like it's naturally wanting to go this way, but we can stamp something on both sides. Oh, let me put another piece of tape on the back side. Let's do this one. You heard something a minute ago. That was my dog sneezing. Alright, so now we've got that on the back. Now let's stamp something on here. I think I have a little... number, maybe. Okay, and what else do we want to do? Stamp something here. I've got some tickets. That color. Let's see. I definitely want something to go there. Oh, maybe we'll do a postmark. Well, that's not a postmark. Okay, now we definitely need since I made that nice tuck, we need something to go in it, don't we? Got this. This is definitely not French. It also has some color on it, so we won't use that. See what else I have in my ephemera for the journal. I don't know if I have anything little. There's some small tickets. No. Tickets, not it. Nope, everything's nope. This is the pocket I have planned to put it in, and now I may have made it too bulky. I would have gone in there. I can't think of anything, guys. I do have, I'm not sure where it is at the moment. Let me look in my book back here. Somewhere I have a vintage driver's license, but I don't think that it is neutral. I'm wanting to say that it's green. Let's see. Just flipping through my ephemera pieces here that are in this book to see. If I see anything. What's this one? Some kind of bee card, bee culture, or something like that. Christmas. Maybe I'll color. Yeah, nothing in there. I don't think any of these are neutral. Or at least neutral, the ones that would fit with the theme are not neutral. Not seeing anything, guys. I'm stumped, I think. This book's in terrible shape because I dropped it, and when I did, everything went flying out. I haven't put them all back in there yet. They're just all kind of sitting on the pages. Thought if I could find one of these that looks like a speedometer, that would kind of work, but most of these are gauges. It's like a parking meter one. That might work for something different. Oh, here's part of a... Nope. I like the parking meter better than that one. Here's one that looks like a road sign. I mean, you couldn't put that in there. Nope. I think I'm gonna go with that. So I think I'm gonna go with that and call it done. I doubt if they even had parking meters at the time of this car, but we're gonna go with it. All right, so there we go. There's our guest check tag. And like I said, you can still see a little bit of color, but for the most part, we're pretty neutral. And I think that's cute with a little tuck back there. You can tuck it in however you like. You could even put something behind that if this hole bothered you. You could put, something back there so that the hole wouldn't show. But I don't mind it. I don't mind it just like that, just with the two sticking up. It's fine with me. So there we go. There is our guest check base make. Next week, the prompt is a paper bag. Any kind of paper bag that you could have. It can be little. It can be big. You could work on a journal cover if you wanted, if you have a big one. If you have a little one, you want to do a pocket. I believe that I am going to use one that's about the size of a lunch bag. And I'm going to make like a folio. So I hope you will tune in for that. And I will see you guys back on Thursday, if not before. But definitely Thursday for I Sell It on Pinterest. And I hope you continue to have a good week. And I will see you the next time. Bye.